everyone. Today I'm going to show you about how to do acrylic full set color. So I already made the last video about how to do acrylic full set with the regular color, but today I'm going to show you about the acrylic full set color. To do acrylic full set color, you have to have this all of the stuff. So I'm going to show you what stuff you have to have when you want to do acrylic full set with the regular or with the color. It's the same thing. So all the stuff that you should have, you have to have the color, like what color you're going to do. I'm going to do the blue, show you the blue today. And this is the primer. Not the primer, it's a liquid that and this is the regular one. So and then you have to have glue and all these tools for the acrylic, okay? The bob, the file, and the clipper, and the cut, and then the tip. All right, so I'm going to put the tip, show you how. Right now I have the client. You see, this is the client hand that come out with the natural nail. So before you do the acrylic full set, you have to cut like all the nail short, okay? And the reason that you cut the nail short, because if you keep the nail underneath long, when you put the tip on the nail, it going to be lifting, you know, when the nail underneath it's long. So you all the time that you do acrylic full set that you put the tip on, you have to cut all the nail short, okay, before you put the tip. All right, so now I start with cut them short, and then I start with the first tool with the machine. So normally when you do acrylic full set, you have to use the machine. This is my first tool that I do. So I start with, so the first time after I cut it, I drill it, okay? So when you drill it, you have to drill it like very close to cuticle. Very close to cuticle, like this. So when you drill, you have to make sure that you clean all the cuticle good, because if you don't clean it very good, the nail it could be lifting, you know. Okay, so after I use that tool, I use the second tool. That this second tool, it help a lot with the clean up the cuticle, okay. So here you go, see that? This little tool, it's clean up really, really good into your skin. It push all your cuticle to the top. See that? When you push it very good like that, when you do acrylic, it just it stay really, really good. This is my style. Like you know, people they have their own style to do the acrylic, but I'm show you it's my style, and we do it in our salon. So all we do is avoid lifting, okay? Alright, after I do that, we start to put the tip. So about the tip, with the tip, okay, so when you put on the tip, you have to make sure that the tip is fit with all the finger good. This is the ring finger. Okay. This tip, it gets stuck. This is okay, and then the middle. And then the pointy. Okay. And this is the thumb. Too big. Uh-oh. We need the second one. The third is not. Okay. We need the second tip. Alright, and then I start to put the tip on. So with the video that I used to do before, I used to show you about how to put the tip on too. So to put the tip on, you have to look at the finger, and then the tip, it's just like this. And then so when you put the tip on, you have to look at like through the finger too. Some finger it's not straight, but you the one that make all the finger, see, like look at all this and then make sure that it's straight. So after I put the tip on, I use this cut. It's a nail tip cut. So when I cut it, yeah, I keep it long. This way, it shows the shape better. So when you cut the tip, you have to hold like the finger, hold it like this. Okay, so I'm going to show you with the shape that I do. I will show you with the square shape today. Normally when I do acrylic, I always, here, let me show you with the file. So when you use the file, normally you have to like side of the bob, it always sharp, so just do that to make sure that it's not cut the shoe customer. Yeah. Okay. I always shape it first before I put acrylic, because I think that after you put acrylic, if you shape after you put acrylic, it very thick. So when it thick, it takes so long to file. So if you file before you put acrylic on, it saves more time. It's quicker. After I file it, I have we have to use this drill again to drill it, wherever you put the tip on, you have to drill it a little bit, make it smooth together like this. And the reason we do it because we want to clean up all the glue out. And this way, when we put the primer, it doesn't ruin, and it also smooth. It doesn't make the tip and your natural nail separated. Just make sure that it's clean like this. Okay. So the next step is to put the primer. So the primer, it helps a lot to make the acrylic and your nail stick together really, really good. Okay. All right, so now it's time for apply the acrylic. So before you do the acrylic, you have to make sure that all the powder is not stuck together and the liquid. Clean the brush good. Okay, now I show you with how to apply the acrylic on. To do the full set, it's a little bit harder than the filling, so you have to make sure that you take enough acrylic and then to put on the finger, you have to make sure that all acrylic is enough for the whole nail. I mean, we have so many ways to do a full set. So normally for me, I always do only one brush full set, like one time acrylic, and then I could do the whole nail. When the nail long like this, sometimes it's hard for you to put the one time acrylic. So if you cannot do one time, you could add it up later, like wherever that it's not enough. See, when you put the acrylic on the finger, you just like make sure the acrylic it not go all over the place. Like make sure all the acrylic it still. Yeah, so the brush you have to like keep tapping on the tapping on the acrylic. It's not like you just tap it like very gently, like very gentle, just to make sure that acrylic it stay together and it's not too like water and make the nail it's too thin, you know. So wherever that you think that the acrylic it's not enough yet, you could add it up a little bit here and there, okay? So normally with the acrylic color, they do it. You don't have to need to polish any color over it. Just put the top coat and then you're good. This one, I put the acrylic just, it's not enough. So I have to put one more. Half more from the front. So like I said, it have so many way to do a full set. You could do just one time, you could do two time, you could do three time. It's depend on like what you want to do, okay? But normally with the longer nail, we always do it with the couple lane. like couple of time of the acrylic, not just only one time, because the nail is long. So if you do only one, it's hard for you to take the powder. So the acrylic full set color and acrylic full set regular, it's not different. We're doing the same way, but acrylic color sometimes it's a little bit harder than the acrylic full set regular, because the powder of the color is different. So some color it dry very quick, some color it dry slow. So that is the hard thing about acrylic color. It depend on the color, which color that you pick, and it's easy or hard. It really depend on the color. Like this color is a little bit hard because it have a sparkle in it. You see all the sparkle. So when I put the acrylic on it, a little bit like, you know, flow on the side. But okay, now it's finished with the acrylic that I put on. So after you finish, with the powder, now you start to shape it. Okay, this is the file that I shape it. So to shape the acrylic nail, normally after you finish with the putting the powder, it when it dry, it a little bit stuck on the side. So before you shape, you have to make sure that the side of the nail and your cuticle is separated. This way it's not hurt. And while you file, you have to hold in like the cuticle and then pull it out like this. And then you put the file into here and then shape it like very gently. This way the customer doesn't feel hurt or anything. And this side too, you have to push it down a little and then put the file into that, and then make sure the file is get into, and then you file the top flat. One is the same thing. Like before you file, you have to push it down and make sure cuticle and the acrylic nail is separated. So this way when you put the file on, it's not hurting the client finger. also with the acrylic full set color. Not many people doing that, because when you do acrylic color, you could go only one time, and then the next time when you come back, you have to, if you want to do the filling, you have to do the same color. If you don't, you want to do another color, it's not gonna look nice, unless you don't mind with the mix of the color. That's why not many people they doing the acrylic color. So if you decide to do it, it's only one time, full set, and then you just soak it off, and then the next time you do another color. Or you could do the gel color on top of it to cover it the next time when you come back, you do the filling. So do the gel color covered, like find the color that cover the acrylic underneath. So after you do that, you cannot like do light color. If you want the light color, you have to soak them off and then do another acrylic set. That's why it's not popular. It's not mean it's not popular, like not many people doing that way. They always do the regular full set and then with the gel color on top of it. They're not doing the color of the acrylic. I just want to make sure that all the nails they look good or not. So normally my techniques, I always like look at the customer finger from this side, because it could tell me all those nails it's nice or not, you know. So when I look at all the nails just this way, they look good already. So now I start with the drill. So the drill, I use the small one. I use the small one to clean out all the acrylic around the cuticle. Like this. This small little drill, it helps a lot to clean out all the acrylic around the cuticle, and also make the top of the cuticle it round. Like when you do it like this, it round on the top like this. It make the nail look even nicer, you know. This. With this small little drill, it help a lot with clean up the underneath of the nail. See that? Yeah, it clean up all the underneath nail. Okay, after I use the small one, now it's time for me to use the smooth. Yeah, the smooth one. So this one, I use it to drill all the acrylic that is not that is thick or something like that around the nail, so just to smooth it out. This one you could pay attention with how I use the drill too, like the way I hold the drill, the way I drill on the side of the finger customer, like what I use, the way I hold, the way I do. It's all the techniques that you learn quick about doing all this thing. Sorry. So when you drill, you have to make sure that you drill only somewhere that needed it, because some places you don't need to drill it. So when you do acrylic, you will know that sometimes you might wonder why, like where should I drill, where should I not drill it, something like that. But when you learn, when you holding the drill, you will know. When you drill on the finger, you will feel like some part that is needed, some part that it doesn't need it. So all this kind of nail, it needs needs like to practice. If you don't practice, you don't know until like you're holding customer finger, and then you will notice all the trick and you will learn little by little. Okay, and now I use another. This is the last drill that I will use, and this one it helps to smooth all the nail before bob. Okay. Thank you. they should do a credit nail. It has so many stuff, so many gel to drill it again and again. Because acrylic nail, it needs you to shape it really good. If you don't shape it good, the nail, it doesn't come out good either. That's why we have to make sure, like, drill it to make the shape and everything smooth and nice. Alright, now I finished with all the drill, and I shape it again. This is the last one that we shape it to finish. Check it out again. This is a square shape that I make it like really, really square. That, and when you put it like this, you could see with the all the shape. This one a little bit. So when you look at this way, all the finger, it's square. And then this is the bob. So when you bob it, you hold the bob like this and put this one this way. If you put this way, it could be cut the customer skin, you know. So normally don't use it this way, use it this way and hold it like this, and then bob it on the top like this, and then to the side, make it like curve, bob it this side, and then the top, just do it like this, because sometimes when you bob it too hard, it make the nail change the shape too. So you, when you bob, you have to like careful too, because the shape, it change very quickly. Like, do it very gentle to the side and then to the another side, and then on the top like this. This is finished, and then I will put the top coat. Clean up with the So before you put the top coat, you clean up the cuticle a little bit here and there that it's still, you know, hanging out there. Make sure all the nails smooth and all the cuticle smooth. Normally, I don't let customer to go wash because when you wash, sometimes the nail it get wet, and then with the gel, if your nail is get wet, it's not dry good, especially on the side of the cuticle. The gel coat it could peel easily. That's why I don't let customer wash. I will let them wash after the top coat. Okay. All right. So now I put the top coat. Okay, and after I put the top coat, just put the nail in the machine for 2 minutes, and then when it dry, the color it will come out with like very shiny. So thank you so much for watching this video, and if you like this video, please help me to like and subscribe my video. And if you want me to make another video or video that you want me to make, just comment on that link or let me know. I will make another video for you guys. Okay, thank you so much. And now I think you could look at the nail again. The nail it's finished. And here, and just put the oil. Like this, and then, okay, this is acrylic full set. Done. It's the acrylic color. Thank you. Bye bye.